first experiment we are going to do it in this lab is frequency and wavelength measurement. So the aim of the experiment is to measure the frequency and wavelength on a microwave bench for a rectangular waveguide. So the list of equipments required for executing this experiment is, so we require Klystron power supply and reflex Klystron oscillator, and we require isolator, we require variable attenuator and frequency meter, standing wave detector, and we require slotted wave section, and we are going to have a termination. So this is how it looks, the block diagram. So in this we have shown gun power supply and gun diode, but this experiment can be executed by choosing Klystron power supply and Klystron oscillator. So and the other blocks will be almost same. So finally we are going to verify the expression of a wavelength, that is 1 by lambda naught square is equal to 1 by lambda g square plus 1 by lambda c whole square. This we are going to verify for a rectangular waveguide. So in this microwave bench, so we are using a cooling fan to control the heat of the source. So first, before starting the experiment, so we have to switch on the cooling fan, and after switching on the cooling fan, so this is a Klystron power supply. So before switching on this power supply, so we have to put the beam, this particular knob, to the minimum position, and there is one more beam which is rippler. That rippler should be in the middle of the scale, and so here we have meter, like voltage, current and rippler. So based on the requirement, we are going to change this knob to the desired position. Now right now it is in switching off mode, and also the modulation should be kept in the AM. So rest everything will be the default, and only thing we have to focus on setting the beam voltage, setting the rippler voltage, and we need to switching on the devices. So now we have switched on the equipment, and we have to switch on HD also. There is one more option, that is HD. So this power supply as well as HD should be in the on mode. When we switch on, so you can see here 181 is the voltage it is showing, but for executing the experiment we require 220 volts as a beam voltage, and the rippler should be above minus 60. So before setting the beam voltage, first we are going to change this knob, that is meter select into rippler, and we are going to change this to above minus 60. See, by changing the knob in the anti-clockwise direction, you can see that the number is changing from minus 130 to minus 64. So our requirement is above minus 60, so we are keeping at minus 64, and then after that we have to switch to the voltage meter select, and then we need to change the beam voltage. So for activating this source we need to keep to 220 volts. So slowly we need to increase the voltage, because when we switch on it is already showing 180 and 190 volts. So slowly we have to switch, and we have to move the voltage to the required voltage, that is 220 volts. So once this Klystron power supply the values are set, then we can connect our bench output terminal. This is the output. So this will be connected to the oscilloscope, that is DSO. So on the DSO, so we are going to get the waveform. So in order to test whether bench is working properly or not, so always a square waveform should be there on the CRO or DSO. So that means wherever you are finding a square waveform, that means the bench is in the working condition. So right now, so at minus 75 rippler voltage, so we are getting this particular square waveform. So then our next step is to measure the frequency. So for measuring the frequency, first we should know what is the operating frequency of this bench. So please remember, whatever the bench we are dealing, that bench is working in the X band, that is 8 to 12 gigahertz frequency. So for measuring the frequency of the given source, so we can identify the frequency by using this particular device called as frequency meter, where you can find a red color vertical line
and there are two horizontal lines, blue lines. The intersection point of these particular things are will be f1 and f2 values. That means the first intersection is nothing but f1 frequency, the second one is f2 frequency. The average of these two, that is f1 plus f2 by 2, will give you the frequency of operation of this particular source. So while changing this frequency meter, so we can identify there is a dip. After the particular dip only, we need to measure the frequency numbers. Because when we switch on the klystron power supply, we are going to get the square waveform at that particular point. So don't take the value of on the frequency meter. So after getting the dip on the oscilloscope, so we need to identify the numbers on this particular scale. So now you can see the values are, one value is near 9.46, 9.46. And the below bottom one is 9.16, approximately 9.16. That is f1 is equal to 9.16 and f2 is equal to 9.465. So average of these two will be the frequency of operation of this particular pitch. After noting down the frequency, we need to disturb this particular frequency meter by rotating in anti-clockwise direction. And then we are going to find the distance between two minimas or two maximas. So in order to measure that one, so we are going to use this slotted section where we are going to vary this particular section. So when you vary this on the CRO, you can observe there is a variation of the magnitude. This is first maxima. So for the first maxima, we need to note down the values on this particular scale. So here you can see there are two scales here. So we need to find out the D1 value. D1 is nothing but main scale plus pitch scale into least count. So main scale value is here. This zero is matching with the, this zero is matching with the, on this particular scale. So this is at 9.5. So main scale is 9.5 and pitch scale is on this particular scale. We need to identify which line is exactly matching with this particular scale, that is your pitch scale. So in this case, so in this, seventh point is exactly matching with the main scale. So the value will be 9.5 is our main scale value and the pitch scale is the seventh one multiplied with the least count. Least count is always 0.01. So if you simplify this, we are going to get the value of D1, which is the first maxima. First maxima.
9.57
is the first maxima. So similarly, we need to find out what is the value of the second maxima, that is D2, by changing the slotted section thing, and we have to observe the waveform on the CRO. You can observe there is a variation on the screen. So this is your next maxima, second maxima. Similarly, we need to find out, so what are the values that are coinciding with the zero, that is 12 is coinciding with the zero. That means main scale is 12, main scale is 12. And pitch scale. Pitch scale means the line which is matching with the main scale. So here in this case, let me zoom it. Fifth is the matching. Fifth one is matching. So 5 into 0.01. Then we are going to get the value of the second maxima, that is D2, that is 12.05. So we got first maxima at 9.57 and second maxima at 12.05. So based on this D1, D2 values, so we are going to find out what is lambda g, guided wavelength. Guided wavelength is given as 2 into d1 minus d2. So we have got d1, d2. So if you multiply the answer with 2, we are going to get the lambda g. Clear? And once lambda g is done, so we can find lambda c. Lambda c as 2 into a. So here we are dealing with the rectangular waveguide. So the value of a is a standard one, 2.286 centimeters. After completing the experiment, noting down the values, we need to keep everything into the reset mode. That means we have to keep the slotted section like this, and we need to select the beam voltage to minimum, and then the rippler voltage will be kept like that, and we have to switch on the HT, and we have to wait till the number is going to come down to zero. After it is coming down to zero, then we have to switch off the main power supply. That is how you have to do the experiment carefully.